Hello everyone and welcome back to another Minecraft video from me. And yeah, this time it's a tutorial again. Sorry, I was in holidays lately, and also, you know, I injured my knee pretty badly, so I had been going through an odyssey of doctors lately, so that's why I didn't have much time for Minecraft, although I said I would. But I can finally yeah, provide you with something new. This is actually a design I already made a while ago, a simple ice farm. And I just posted this tutorial because Doc said he was going to build something similar in his world tour and needed a simple design. And so I showed him this and he said, well, why don't you make a tutorial out of it? So let's just directly get started and so show you how it works. So over here, the ice is being produced whenever an ice block freezes here, just being pushed over. And as you can see, there is a second trigger here, which pushes the ice upwards as soon as it reaches the end. And that means this cube will slowly fill up with ice blocks when you wait here or FK here for several hours. And in the end, you can mine this all in one go. It's a cube of 9x9x9 blocks, and I intentionally didn't make it higher than 9 blocks so that you can easily reach all blocks with an instant mine Sig Touch pickaxe, but it's obviously with a diamond one. And the redstone is actually not really that complicated, and the nice thing about this farm is that you can just usually when you need ice, you all of a sudden need a huge amount. So this farm is not really that quick in producing ice, but well, it produces them just whenever you are at your base or somewhere else where there's an ice biome, and then you can go and mine a lot of ice very quickly because it conveniently places you the ice in a square form. So over here I've built up a similar platform. The core redstone of the design needs 13 by 19 blocks, and well, you can just place it anywhere where you have a big surface in a taiga biome which is high enough, or an ice place biome, or any biome where you're sure that the ice will actually freeze. And first step is to dig a 9x9 hole, and let me do this really quickly. And in the other direction as well. And this will be the hole where you will finally build the ice. And the design itself is 12 meters deep. So you need to go and, well, go 12 meters within the ground. Obviously, you can also build the whole design over ground and then just cover the sides. Here you can see how big it is going to be. And the different steps are actually rather simple. So you go 12 blocks deep, and then from this side here, let's start in the corner, we have pistons 4 blocks above the floor, as you can see over there. So what we start off with, we first of all need to decide in which orientation we are going to build this, and then go 1 block off from the corner and just place a row of blocks till you reach the other side. So that should be 9 blocks in total, so till over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and it was still 1 block too much. Let me check. Yeah, so that's perfect. And as you can see, this is just a setup to build or to power all the pistons below. And for that, we just need some very simple redstone components. So a repeater every second block, and we alternate the design inside. Same goes for this side here. And redstone everywhere in the middle. The next layer here consists out of torches, then solid blocks above. And next layer of solid blocks. So this whole design is just meant to power all the pistons, which will be pushing up the cube. So just attach torches to all sides of these blocks here, so to all three sides. And that shouldn't take too long to finish. Let's see. Here we go. And then we just need solid blocks above the torches facing to the side, and after that a complete layer of pistons above. So, and for the pistons, I'm going to use Bolt Edit, since that's probably going to be a little bit quicker. Ah, wait. Okay, here we go. After we place the piston, we'll place four layers of gravel on every spot. The reason is, we'll otherwise interfere with the butt switch over here. If you move those pistons up, they will get bothered by these blocks, which are necessary for the butt switch over here to work. And also, the block, if it's too tall, is just a little bit inconvenient to mine. So I decided to just put four layers of gravel here and solve the problem the easy way. Alright, next step. Well, the next step is going to be we need the additional layer where we actually generate the ice. And that's going to be a stripe 3 wide away from our core where we built the pistons. And this is also going to be... let's check it again. So, we dig the stripe 4 blocks deep and then there are the pistons, so 5 meters down. Let's do this real quickly. So. So, pistons are going to be 4 meters below the floor, and just as many pistons as there are blocks, so that is 9. But additionally, we need another sticky piston at the side here, which will trigger as soon as any of them gets updated, because this one is also will be butt powered, and all those pistons will be butt powered from a layer on the side here. So I recommend you to clear out all the space here to be able to build this easier. And we power these blocks with a row of repeaters. And yeah, before we actually go and build the next step, I think it's probably the easiest to start placing the water. That means, since you're probably going to have not space everywhere, you need to dig this all away, but that should not be much of a deal, I hope. We need water at the side of these pistons here, and this water is just going to flow into the position of the ice farm as soon as another ice block has been pushed out. So we can actually fill this whole area in. There we go. And, well, it's not really necessary, but we could already cover the sides here. But recommend to use any block which works well with the aesthetics of the farm, as you can see over here. I used a combination of a dark oak wood and a cyan, or better say, gray, dark gray stained clay. And this looks pretty cool in my opinion, but as you know, I'm not really the perfect designer. So that's up to you on how you want to build this up. Okay. So, what do we need next? Well, we below the pistons, we need a little bit of space, and for that we're just gonna get 2 meters further down, and actually, it's probably best if I start building this row first of all. So, this row here will contain redstone and repeaters, which will reactivate the butt switch as soon as this has been triggered once. Relatively simple mechanism, as you can see. And it's directly next to the piston row here. That means we need a solid layer of blocks here, then torches, and as you can already see, I made a little mistake here and I forgot the last block. It's also very important. So, now we are butting all these pistons here, and as soon as one of them triggers, well, they will extend. Now, the next step is that we need to reset those pistons here. So, how are we going to do this? Well, two steps. First of all, we need to remove the power in order to retract the pistons at all. So, 3 repeaters, 1 on 2 ticks will do the job. And then, this will power them. So, there we go. We retracted the thing. Now, we don't only want to move the ice blocks upwards, but also to the sides. And as you see, it already triggered, because we are already in a plates biome. If you don't want to have anything triggering while you're building it, just cover this up with anything which blocks the melting of the ice. That would be glass blocks, for example. Better say the freezing, not the melting, of course. Okay. Yeah, so we need another block here. And this is just going to power the sideways facing pistons. Those pistons need to be exactly where we push the ice blocks to, so over here. And I just noticed I covered this beforehand with these wood blocks. That was my fault. Sorry. My bad. Here we go. And the last one is not necessary. So it should face towards the area where we are going to push up the ice blocks. So behind that, we need to obviously power them. That's why I got this torch tower here set up. So anytime another ice block freezes, this should probably push them to the side. There we go. Okay. So, that you can better see how this is going to work, we'll have ice blocks over here, and this part of the machine is already working, and now we need to hurry up in order to have the other part done as soon as the ice has reached over. Let's see whether we can do this. Okay, so I just noticed for some reason the hole here was one block too large. At the very end, we need pistons to detect whether an ice block reaches the end, so we just have those pistons here, and they do serve no other purpose than to update this sticky piston with a redstone block in front at the side. So this is next to the other pistons, just directly after the row ends. Pretty simple. I hope you can easily figure out where to place it, even if you have to dig all the blocks away first of all, in case you're building it underground. Okay, and we are updating it with blocks, just one block diagonally from it. And to power these blocks here, we'll set repeaters on full delay. And they should also power the very last block, because this just is going to act the same way as all other blocks. Okay, on the side here, got a redstone torch. And a simple connection line between the two setups here, and that is this. And that's pretty much already it. If you wait long enough, it will also actually trigger twice, but you can see how this is working. It's just going to update every time one of these pistons receives an update by an ice block being pushed to it. And now we simply need to connect it to the floor extending ones. It's the very simple part at the end here. Here we go! So, we're already almost done with our farm. Now just the additional convenient features are going to be added. That is, first of all, it's a little bit inconvenient to mine the ice blocks and at the same time trigger all these butted pistons every time you mine a block somewhere close to them. So I decided I would add a lever somewhere to disable the whole thing while it's running. So to do that, we go one block out, then go ahead and place a lever like this. What I originally did was, let me get a ladder here. As you can see in the other design, I just had this entrance here with a ladder. You can jump up and you can trigger this lever here in order to toggle whether a farm should be disabled or not. Okay, and we simply need to connect it to the other side. Let's actually build it exactly the same way as we did over there. So what I used was, I used the dark stained clay, but in this case, and let me just stick with the iron blocks. This design is not meant to be looking fancy. Anyway, we got redstone lamp. They are just indicating that it's actually turned off, but it's not really necessary, of course. On the side here, I'm just powering this torch. And in order to do that, that's what we need. So switching this level will trigger the butt switch once, and after that it's blocked. Now you can see nothing is going to happen, because, well, these pistons are just not powered anymore. This way is the way you can build up an override switch to avoid the butt switch being triggered when you mine those ice blocks. So the only thing which is remaining now is, yeah, to make it all fancy. So I decided those lamps are actually in the floor, because otherwise they would melt the nearby ice blocks. You obviously need to cover them from the side as well to prevent any melting anywhere. Just like this. And then we can frame this all in with a block of your choice. And you get the point how it's going to work. As long as the butt switch is turned off, there's also no risk in placing blocks anywhere close to that. You can also build a frame around this, like over here, so that you can't accidentally fall into the hole. And beside that, the actual mechanics of this thing are already set up. As you could see, it already triggered several times here while we were building. Let's just test it one more time. And it starts working, and you will see during the fill-up process, you will see structures like this. And in the end, you will end up with a solid cube and can mine it anytime you want. I hope this tutorial was easy to understand and not too lengthy at the same time. And that it is actually a useful design and simple enough for you to build it up without no big trouble. Anyway, thank you for watching and see you next time.